Okay, so I'm looking for my favorite clothing store here in Vienna. So I'm gonna type in clothing store near me, and it's not coming up. Unikatessen sells unique, funky, and simply amazing clothing that I want in my closet right now. But as you just saw, they're not showing up on the Google map and what SEOs call the local pack. And there's one real simple reason for it. They haven't optimized their Google Business Profile. Google Business Profile is a 100% free tool that allows you to influence how your business appears on Google Search, Google Maps, and Google Shopping. So today, I'm gonna help out my friend Dani at Unikatessen and optimize her Google My Business Profile so that she can get more people in her store. Now, in order to do this, we are going to focus on the three things that Google tells us will improve local rankings: relevance, distance, and prominence. When it comes to relevance, we're really talking about how closely your business matches whatever it is a searcher was looking for when they typed something into that little box. Now, Unikatessen calls itself a concept store. Unfortunately, the keyword magic tool tells me that nobody in Austria seems to be searching for this term in Google. So that's a damn shame. What they are actually typing in though is clothes shop near me, which has 390 average monthly searches, and even more so, clothing store with 18,100 average monthly searches in Austria. Now, there's an important lesson here. The keyword phrase your hunch tells you to pick might not get enough monthly searches. That can happen when the words you use in your business as an expert in the field don't actually match up with the words your customers, who are maybe less knowledgeable, would use when they are searching for a business or service like yours. This is why it is so, so important to conduct keyword research before you fill out your Google Business Profile, and honestly, even before you pick a business name. To explore this topic in more depth, you can check out the great course by Wes McDowell linked in the notes below. I honestly cannot recommend it enough. Okay, back to Unikatessen. We want them to show up for both clothing store and clothing store near me keywords. So we want to include clothing store somewhere, somehow, right? So the first place that we could put this keyword in is the actual store name. Unikatessen could choose to change their official business name from Unikatessen Concept Shop to Unikatessen Clothing Store, but should they do it just to please Google? Here's the deal. It definitely helps if the keyword phrase you're trying to rank for is in your business name. But this can be really tricky because Google doesn't allow you to stuff keywords in your business name field unless it's in the actual name of your business. Now, Unikatessen Clothing Store, honestly, to me, feels a little bit spammy, which is why I'm not touching the name of the business. And instead, I am making sure that we focus on the next and most important place that you can add keywords in your profile, and that is your category. Now, Google offers over 4,000 different business categories, and it's important to know that if you choose the wrong one, it can actually hurt you. For example, a yoga studio that sets its primary category as gym instead of yoga studio could be considered the wrong category because it doesn't really reflect the specific services offered by the business, and it might make it a lot harder for potential customers to find the studio when they're searching for yoga. So you want to make sure that you choose the category that not only is the closest thing to what you actually offer, but also the one that is the closest to the keyword phrase you're actually trying to rank for. So I'm gonna go in here and edit the category for Unikatessen's Google Business Profile. First thing I'm gonna do is select clothing shop as the primary category because that's the closest thing to clothing store, which is our target keyword. Now I'm gonna select other relevant categories that can help me rank for other stuff that people might be searching for in this area, such as vintage shop, secondhand shop, and fashion accessories shop. Note that I can add up to 10 categories here, but I'm gonna stop because these are the actual relevant categories that make sense for Unikatessen. In the past, experts have warned about the dangers of what they used to call category dilution, meaning that the more categories you choose, the less impact each one has. But that's turning out to not really be a thing after all, at least not anymore. Though there is such a thing as category confusion. So if you choose a bunch of categories unrelated to what it is you actually do or sell, not only is that not even helping you, it's actually hurting your ability to rank for what you actually want to rank for, because Google will probably be really confused and they won't really know what you do at all. So when you're choosing categories, make sure that you choose relevant ones and never mislead people with your categories. Okay. Another part of your profile that can strengthen your relevance is your photos. According to Google, listings with photos get 35% more clicks through to their websites than businesses that don't have photos. It's also been shown that adding photos that are really relevant to your business category can help you, because Google's AI can see what's in the photo and tie your business back to its category. So for Unikatessen, I am adding a high quality, non-stock cover photo, as well as some photos of their team members, their interior, and their exterior. I'm also gonna add a business description for the store and include my keywords in there as well. Okay, the next thing Google really cares about when it comes to local search results is distance. Both proximity of your business to the searcher and having a physical address in the city that's being searched. There's really not a lot that you can do about those two things. Just make sure that you add the right information to your profile. And when I say the right information, I'm really talking about name, address, and phone number. You want these three elements to be exactly the same in every single place where your business is mentioned online. This can include directories, blog posts, other websites, or even data aggregators. If your business information is inconsistent or outdated between sites, this can cause confusion and even hurt your SEO. For Unikatessen, name and address are consistent, but the phone number is not. So I'm gonna go ahead and add it here. By the way, do not feel pressure to add your personal cell phone number in there. You can use a service like Google Voice to set up a business phone number and avoid spam on your personal line. One time I put my cell phone number in a moving company website and I'm still getting calls by moving companies. Still asking me when I'm moving. Like, don't put your personal information unless you want people to call you.
Forever.
Little known fact, you don't necessarily need a physical address to manage a Google business profile. Besides physical storefronts, businesses that travel to their customers also qualify. For example, many plumbers don't operate from a formal storefront or office, but they can still manage a Google business profile page. If you engage with customers in person, you are eligible to run a business profile. Examples of businesses that don't qualify: online-only businesses, rental or for sale properties, and lead generation companies. Sorry, friends. The final known local search ranking factor is prominence. Prominence determines just how popular your local business is, and this is where reviews come in. The single biggest factor here is your overall star rating itself. In other words, it's more helpful to have fewer but better reviews than to have hundreds of mixed reviews. It also helps to have reviews with actual text above and beyond a simple star rating. And even better, to get some that mention the keyword phrase you want to rank for. Unikatessen is crushing it here. They basically only have 5-star reviews because they're awesome. Ooh, that's mine. I would encourage them to keep asking customers to share Google reviews and also to reply to the ones they already have, which is what I'm gonna do right now. Now, whether your reviews are positive or negative, Google encourages you to respond to each one as it shows that you are an engaged business owner. Below, I added a link to an article where Google shares best practices and even scripts for answering those dreaded negative reviews. No shame on those. They happen to the best of us. Finally, the last thing that you should know is that you should always, always, always keep your Google business profile up to date. Add new photos as you get them, add new offers and promotions from time to time as well. When you do that, Google then knows that you are an actual real business that is active and that you care enough to keep your customers updated. Trust me, this can go a long way in how they treat your listing. Okay, so that's it. If you want to learn more about this topic, which I love, I could not recommend Wes's course more. You can check out the link below. To my local business owners, where are you getting stuck when it comes to your Google business profile? Ask your questions below and we will do our best to answer them. See you in the next one.